Taking a refreshing dip in the sea can be a hazardous business today if you're not careful. Thanks to global warming, all sorts of dangerous animals are swimming amongst us in the water. Scary thought, right? Well, don't be afraid. There were times in the past when going anywhere near the ocean would have been downright nuts.
My goodness.
Ancient sea creatures big enough to crush boats beneath their jaws and vicious predatory whales with razor-sharp teeth are amongst the bizarre and deadly monsters that roam the Earth's ancient oceans. Here are the 15 deadliest sea creatures that ever existed. Number 15. Leviathan Malavali, aka Big Whale with Huge Teeth. A Peruvian desert has turned out to be the final resting place of an ancient sperm whale with teeth much bigger than those of the largest of today's sperm whales. The fossil, dated at 12 to 13 million years old, belonged to a new but extinct genus and species big enough that it probably hunted other whales. The robust snout and massive lower and upper teeth of this animal are evidence that its prey were larger and tougher than squid. It's been hypothesized that due to many of these features, they occupied a giant killer whale-like niche and preyed upon baleen whales and other large marine mammals. The mouth of this creature is approximately 6 feet long and 4 feet wide, three times the size of the mouth of the killer whale, and large enough to fit an adult human or the entire head of a Tyrannosaurus rex inside. Based on the size of an approximately 10-foot long skull and on comparisons with other sperm whales, this animal had a body length of 45 to 60 feet. You want to know a little secret? If you smash the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell, you'll have superpowers for the rest of your life. So what are you waiting for? Time to fly. Number 14, the Triassic Kraken. Fishermen once told tales of a giant sea monster, the Kraken. You know, the famous line from Clash of the Titans, "Release the Kraken."
Release the Kraken.
The beast dragged men from their boats to their death, drowning them at the bottom of the ocean. We now know that the Kraken is real. The story is referring to species of giant squid, and while it's highly unlikely the squid are capable of killing fishermen, they are huge, among the largest invertebrates known. It sounds like a Halloween tale, but researchers who first suggested the existence of this ancient sea monster in 2011 say they now have more evidence backing up their controversial theory. Not only have they discovered a fossil that appears to be the beak of an ancient squid or octopus, during the Paleozoic and Mesozoic eras, cephalopods like the Kraken dominated the seas. Voracious and omnivorous predators, wildly adapted survivors, cephalopods' reign lasted longer than the dinosaurs. They survived an even greater extinction event, the Permian extinction, when volcanoes in Siberia erupted for a solid 100,000 years. Blotting out nearly 96% of all marine life. Number 13. Gensu shark. With a name like that, you know it's deadly. The Gensu shark was a fearsome and now extinct predator nicknamed for the similarity between its teeth and the blades of a popular brand of knife. The tooth's size indicates that the shark measured roughly 7 feet long, the biggest shark of its time. It was near the top of the food chain, and it had a diet that included almost anything that it wanted. There's also strong evidence for its predation of the bony fish Xiphactinus, a 4 to 6 meter long predator itself, and even the large turtles of the day were fair game for the Gensu shark. With teeth over 2 inches long, they were so smooth and had thick enamel, suggesting that they were for working against tough shells and bones. Like the advert for Gensu knives said, they could cut through anything. And the Gensu shark probably had little difficulty in removing bite-sized chunks from whatever prey item it chose. It might not have been a massive predator, just a very effective one. Number 12. Tussotothes. Good cephalopod fossils are hard to find. Paleontologists seldom get to see the characteristic soft tissue anatomy of these mini-armed swimmers. Finds are so rare that one from 1982 still stands out, a 165 million year old fossilized octopus uncovered in France. Tussotothes, meaning crushed squid, is an extinct genus of a very large cephalopod that lived during the Cretaceous period. Although often called a squid, it's now thought to be more closely related to modern octopuses. Tussotothes is assumed to have preyed on other cephalopods, fish, and possibly even small marine reptiles. Despite its size, which was around 20 to 35 feet long with tentacles fully outstretched, what's almost as freaky is the size of a giant squid eyeball, a staggering 10.5 inches across. A squid's eyeballs lack the jelly-like substance that gives ours their shape. Instead, they're filled with water, which leaks out once the invertebrate dies. The eyes collapse like a plastic bag. You do not want that eye staring back at you while you swim. Number 11. Talatorkin. Talatorkin was a genus of primitive lizardfish that stands out as one of the earliest marine reptiles to be an apex predator of large aquatic animals. What this means is that rather than focusing on small prey like shoaling fish and squid, this animal most probably hunted the smaller creatures like themselves. The total length of these animals were estimated to have been at least 28 feet. It's thought that they once were the first marine macro predators capable of eating prey that was similar to size of itself, an ecological role that can be compared to that of modern orcas. The teeth of these massive animals were large, flattened, and have cutting edges on the front and rear. These are not the teeth of a piscivore, a fish eater, since predators that hunt fish usually have thin needle-like teeth to pierce the slippery skin and scales of fish. The teeth of this animal instead were supremely adapted to slicing through the flesh and muscle of other marine animals. And trust me, we had no doubt whatsoever. Number 10. Mega Piranha. A popular B-movie star of many creature features and popular movies, the ancient carnivorous Mega Piranha. Yeah, it's probably as bad as it sounds, lived between 6 million and 10 million years ago and packed a devastating bite with a force that was up to 50 times its weight. A new study shows that Mega Piranha chomped with a force of up to 1,000 pounds per square inch, or about 50 times its own body weight, around 20 to 30 pounds. That powerful force allows the piranha to quickly bite whole chunks of flesh from animals as they pass by. You wouldn't want to encounter any piranha, small or large, ever. And you can see why. They have razor-sharp teeth and a voracious hunger for meat. Plus, they tend to swarm and devour prey much larger than them, whatever gets in their way. And today, piranhas have even been known to bite off the toes of unwary human beachgoers, although, who swims at a beach where piranhas might live? Even worse, they feast in swarms, so you can imagine what a giant piranha could do with a bite like that. Number 9. Shonisaurus. This creature sure is a mysterious marine reptile. According to local accounts, the first bones of Shonisaurus popularis were found near the mining town of Berlin, Nevada, about 1869. Stories are told of miners using the large, round vertebrae as dinner plates, but these stories are apparently unsubstantiated. But we kind of hope it's true. It seems to be a very unlikely place to find fossils of anything, let alone a group of 50-foot-long Shonisaurus laid out on the side of a mountain at an altitude of over 7,000 feet in the middle of the desert. How does that ever happen? At more than 50 feet in length and 40 tons, Shonisaurus popularis was for many years the largest known ichthyosaur in the world, and is still the largest from the United States. The recent recovery of the remains of a 50-foot specimen in Canada has dramatically shown that even larger marine reptiles have existed, but does not take away from the paleontological importance of these large late Triassic creatures. And how amazing to find so many fossils together in one place. Incredible indeed. Number 8. Tully Monster. Evolution can be very weird sometimes, producing creatures that are so bizarre looking, you might think they must be aliens. Such is the case with the Tully Monster, a marine animal that kind of looked like a giant slug and lived about 300 million years ago. Now, a new study shows that this ancient creature may have even been more mysterious than previously thought. The famed Tully Monster fossil was first discovered in Illinois in the 1950s. Ever since it was found, scientists have been unable to agree on whether Tully was a vertebrate with a backbone or an invertebrate with no backbone. The once living creature is indeed one of the strangest ever discovered.
It's a really bizarre looking creature.
With a slug-like body and long thin appendage ending in a claw-like structure with two rows of conical teeth. Its eyes are at the end of long thin stalks, or rigid bars, like something out of a science fiction movie. But no doubt, as ugly cute as they may have been, best not to mess with the Tully Monster. Number 7. The Dunkleosteus. About 358 million years ago, a shallow sea filled with marine life covered Northeast Ohio and a lot of the United States, but it was there the Dunkleosteus, the largest predator and one of the fiercest creatures alive in the Devonian Age of Fishes, ruled the subtropical waters. Up to 20 feet in length and weighing more than 1 ton, this fish, with self-sharpening fangs, was capable of chopping prehistoric sharks into bits. Cleveland Museum's Lee Hall describes the fish's gnarly bite like this. Imagine a big guy with an axe swinging down as hard as he can while another guy swings upward. Whoa. Dunkleosteus had a massive skull made of thick, bony plates and two sets of fang-like protrusions near the front of powerful jawbones. But one thing that this creature didn't have was true teeth, like we know of today. Instead, the skull's bony plates extended into sharpened fangs in front of the mouth. These fangs scraped together, continuously sharpening each other as the fish opened and closed its jaws. Number 6. Sarcosuchus, King of the Crocodiles. Most people have never heard of Sarcosuchus, but may well know it by its more popular name of Super Croc. This is because this animal remains one of the biggest crocodiles ever to live, with upper size estimates approaching 40 feet long. In 1964, the first skull was discovered and the type species could then be established. However, it wasn't until the closing years of the 20th century when teams recovered more complete material, including vertebra, ribs, and other parts of the skeleton. Although not complete, there is now enough material to give a more accurate estimate on the potential size of this creature. It was easily one of the largest reptiles, reaching an average estimate of 30 feet and 3.9 tons. Today's crocodiles are simply dwarfed in comparison. But it wasn't until it grew bigger and older that the jaws began to widen. The tip of the upper jaw also hooked downwards, another adaptation seen in other fish-eating crocodiles. Obviously an unmatched hunter, and first-class fisherman. Number 5. Prehistoric frilled shark. There are more than 500 species of sharks swimming in our oceans today, and these species differ greatly in their shapes, sizes, feeding habits, and behavior. But one very primitive shark genus, known as the frilled shark, sticks out from the rest, considering it actually looked nothing like the sharks we're familiar with. Instead, it looked strikingly more like an eel. But it's not an eel. Prehistoric frilled sharks grew to about 4 feet long and lived ages prior to larger land-dwelling dinosaurs thundering into the global scene. So very odd and so very scary. In hunting and eating prey that are tired or exhausted or dying, the frilled shark curves and coils its anguline body and braces its rear fins against a hard surface for leverage to effect a rapid strike bite that captures the prey. The wide gape of the dissented long jaws allow devouring whole prey that are more than half the size of the frilled shark itself. With its jaws, 300 recurved teeth readily snag and capture, the frilled shark has a relatively weak bite, but that doesn't make it any less deadly. Number 4. The Helicoprion. Originally thought to be a shark with terrifying saw-like teeth, the Helicoprion is actually a 270 million-year-old fish that swam around North America, Europe, Asia, and Australia. The fossils of buzzsaw Helicoprion have long mystified scientists because, for the most part, the only remains of the fish are its spiral scissor teeth. And this is where it gets terrifying. Similar to a spiral saw blade, the jaw created a rolling back and slicing mechanism, so you can just imagine the fish literally sawing its way through a good meal. No wonder they thought if it was a shark. It likely ate soft tissue prey such as squid or octopus, rather than hunting creatures with shells or hard skeletons, although it's certain they could probably eat whatever they liked with chompers like that. And you can see for yourself, the Iowa State University's Museum of Natural History has the largest public collection of Helicoprion spiral teeth fossils in the world. Number 3. Ancient giant isopod. If you've ever poked a pill bug and watched it curl up in a ball, you've encountered an isopod. They're not actually bugs, they're crustaceans. And while the terrestrial kind are small and relatively harmless, their deep-sea cousins are a little more, let's say, intense. Chief among these sea bottom dwellers are giant isopods, scientifically known as Bathynomus giganteus. They're related to the common potato bug seen in gardens, but are an ancient ancestor. Giant isopods existed more than 160 million years ago, before the breakup of the supercontinent Pangaea. The species is 200 to 300 million years old. Part of the reason these creatures have survived for so long is their ability to muddle through periods of famine.
So we're currently at a depth of 845 meters.
Giant isopods can go a remarkable 4 years without food, but they are carnivores, and when they can find a big haul, like a whale carcass, they feast to the point of compromising their locomotive ability, according to the aquarium. But food falls are incredibly rare, so it's worth it. Who doesn't like a meal to suddenly appear? I say dig in. Number 2. Oarfish, the ancient serpent. A remotely operated vehicle has come face to face with the world's longest known bony fish, and video footage of the rare encounter has now surfaced. The giant oarfish was found in the northern Gulf of Mexico, where 4 other observations were reported. However, the giant oarfish is rarely seen alive. Could the giant oarfish floating at the surface be mistaken for something else? Of course it can. It's believed that the oarfish may be responsible for many of the legendary sightings of sea monsters and sea serpents by ancient mariners and beachgoers. The Loch Ness Monster sound familiar? However, the origin of the ancient oarfish is unknown, yet the modern oarfish is thriving and not considered to be an endangered species. Unusual oarfish fact? Some people claim that oarfish washing ashore is a sign that an earthquake will soon follow. If you do come across its path, it's definitely a sign. Maybe not of an impending natural disaster, but still. Number 1. Sharkzilla. The evolutionary history of this Sharkzilla is thought to stretch back 105 million years, making the lineage of this creature over 100 million years old. It's called a megalodon. The enormous shark dominated the oceans worldwide until becoming extinct just 3.6 million years ago, and was not only the biggest shark in the world, but one of the largest fish ever to exist. Without a complete skeleton, these figures are based on the size of the animal's teeth, which can reach over 6 inches long. With its large serrated teeth, these giants loved meat, like whales and large fish. Probably other sharks even, as the megalodon would have eaten whatever it needed to eat. And if you're that big, you need to eat a lot. So large prey is essential. This would have included animals as small as dolphins and as large as humpback whales. So the megalodon had to be able to open its mouth wide. It's estimated that its jaw would span 8 feet by 12 feet wide, easily big enough to swallow 2 adult people side by side. These jaws were lined with 276 teeth. So in all likelihood, you wouldn't be swallowed whole. That beast would have eaten you alive. Those were 15 of the deadliest sea creatures that ever existed. Thanks for watching.